Welcome to our discussion on the deflated Sharpe ratio, an essential tool in the evaluation of investment strategies. In the next few minutes, we will explore what it is, how to compute it, and its significance in strategy assessment. The Sharpe ratio, a widely used risk-adjusted return measure, becomes insufficient when multiple trials are run to optimize a strategy, leading to high values due to chance. That's where the deflated Sharpe ratio comes into play. It modifies the original Sharpe ratio by accounting for the number of trials performed, offering a more realistic measure of the strategy's performance. You can calculate the deflated Sharpe ratio with four crucial pieces of information. First, you'll need the original Sharpe ratio of your strategy. Next, consider the number of optimization trials you've conducted for your strategy. The third piece of the puzzle is your chosen significance level for testing the excess return of your strategy. And finally, you should be aware of the skewness and kurtosis of your strategy's returns. Now, let's dive into how it's calculated. Deflated Sharpe ratio equals to Sharpe ratio multiply by multiple testing adjustment multiply by non-normality adjustment. Start with the original Sharpe ratio, which is the ratio of the mean excess return to the standard deviation of returns. Multiply it by a factor that adjusts for multiple testing. This factor is based on the inverse normal cumulative distribution function and depends on the significance level and the number of trials or backtests. Multiply it by another factor that adjusts for non-normality of returns. This factor depends on the skewness and kurtosis of returns and the original Sharpe ratio. Let's say you have a trading strategy that has an annualized return of 15% and an annualized volatility of 10%. The risk-free rate is 2%. The strategy has a skewness of minus 0.5 and a kurtosis of 4.5. You have tested this strategy on 10 years of monthly data, so N equals 120. You want to know if this strategy has a statistically significant Sharpe ratio at the 5% significance level. First, we need to calculate the original Sharpe ratio. Next, we need to calculate the multiple testing adjustment. Where phi is the cumulative distribution function of the standard normal distribution and phi to the degree of minus 1 is its inverse function. Finally, we need to calculate the non-normality adjustment. Now we can plug these values into the formula for the deflated Sharpe ratio. The deflated Sharpe ratio is lower than the original Sharpe ratio, which means that the strategy's performance is inflated by multiple testing and non-normality. To test if the deflated Sharpe ratio is statistically significant, we can compare it to a critical value that depends on the significance level and the number of trials. The critical value can be approximated by the following formula. And for our example, this gives critical value equals approximately 2.1. Since the deflated Sharpe ratio is lower than the critical value, we cannot reject the null hypothesis that the strategy's performance is due to luck at the 5% significance level. Therefore, we conclude that this strategy does not have a statistically significant Sharpe ratio and we should be cautious about investing in it. The deflated Sharpe ratio offers protection against overfitting and data mining pitfalls, providing a more realistic risk-adjusted return of our strategy. By comparing it to a critical value, we can test the statistical significance of our strategy's performance. If the deflated Sharpe ratio is higher than the critical value, our strategy is likely superior to the benchmark. Conversely, if it's lower, we should approach our strategy's performance with some skepticism. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos on finance and investing. Also, feel free to leave a comment below if you have any questions or feedback, and don't forget to check out Community tab on YouTube channel page. Thank you for watching and see you next time.